I'm a YouTuber and I like to think I'm one of the most diverse maker channels. Do everything from welding, CNC aluminium, 3D printing and basically making mechanical things, but also then control systems and doing that software integration. So pretty much everything end to end. Yeah, it's diversity, I guess, to make all of these things. Probably started making things when I was a child. There's some pictures of me less than 10 with a robot made of some chattering teeth, some bits of Meccano, screwed to plywood, an egg box and all of that good stuff. Worked in IT for 20 years prior to doing YouTube full-time, but I always kept my hand in building robots and bits and pieces. And these are some of the historic walking robots. Some of the very early ones were made of wood and things like that, and it was back in the day where there weren't really cheap parts. But pretty much the things are made on a weekly basis. Yes, I can CAD things up quicker than I can 3D print them or make them. That's where it starts, or it starts with a concept. Sometimes I might investigate electronics first to check things work. Like my barcode scanner guitar, I actually built the barcode scanner thing first to check I could scan barcodes and output MIDI notes, and then I built the rest of the mechanics. I do a lot of 3D printing. I have currently 12 machines. I used to do a lot more 3D printing, but I'm getting into metal a lot more now. So projects can have that strong structure under them. So pretty much all those tools and then all the electronics, so Arduinos and all the code and libraries and third-party modules that go with those. And then at the moment I'm getting into interfacing third-party software, so OpenCV for vision tracking and all of that stuff. So I originally got the Axminster lathe for some parts on OpenDog, which is down behind me, to basically turn down the aluminium backs of the motors. So they're drone, big drone motors, and they have a piece that fits on the back so you can put two rotors on for push and pull. Anyway, I need to fit an encoder on the back there, but that shaft is 10mm and the biggest adapter for the encoder is 8mm, and I had to do 12 of them. So I started with bits of studding screwed into 3D prints bolted on, which wasn't very good. That's really why I got the lathe, to do all 12 accurately. My main current project is Performance Robot, and that is going to be an ongoing stage show building robots for performance and building them to do talks about STEM education. Essentially an ongoing, reliable, transportable, robust project that I can take to places. So we've got DC brushed motors in the arms, which are driven by encoders, and we've got brushless motors in the shoulder here, which is driven with an encoder and an O-Drive robotics brushless motor driver, and some bigger brushless motors driving these ball screws, which drive the bigger axis. In the past, I built a lot more movie props. So I built an Iron Man suit, which is where most of my subscribers came from, and then I built an Iron Man Hulkbuster suit. Also built quite a lot of Star Wars droids. My top view video is the 4-year project to build an Iron Man suit, compressed into 4 minutes. It's had over 60 million views. So the core robotics and educational stuff isn't as popular, so they don't get quite as many views. My plan is to use that and use what I've learned from doing those projects to go back to doing more pop culture. I think that it definitely inspires people, so I did have another university contact me to build OpenDog to try and find out what all the parts are, which I haven't documented. But generally I've come up with a better idea since I started building it or something else, so I tend to advise people not to copy it exactly. But it's good that people are inspired.